The Sunday school lesson for September 24th, 2023 is Jesus Prevents Two Stonings, John chapter 8, verses 1 through 11, and verses 56 through 59. To the viewers and subscribers, welcome to my channel, The Backstory. I am Audrey. If you are new here, please notice the agenda. I will share the backstory, read the lesson text, and offer a brief lesson summary. The backstory. Let's begin. The events and teachings recorded in John 7 and 8 occurred during one of Jesus' visits to Jerusalem for the Festival of Tabernacles, John chapter 7, verses 1 through 2. God instituted this festival for two reasons. First, it was a time of thanksgiving during the season of the olive and fruit harvest, the September-October time frame. Second, it was a time to remember deliverance from slavery in Egypt, Leviticus chapter 23, verses 33 through 44. As something of an object lesson, many who celebrated this festival would live in tents or tabernacles outside the city to reenact the 40 years that the Israelites had lived in tents while wandering in the wilderness. Then they all went home. John chapter 7, verse 53, closes the day before the events considered in the first half of this lesson. The second half of this lesson begins in John chapter 8, verse 56. In John chapter 8, 12 through 55, not in our printed text, Jesus responded to questions from a crowd of both lay people, some who believed him, others who did not, and Pharisees. Of particular interest to the following episode are the conversational threads about being Adam's descendants. Despite the Jews' confidence that they were Adam's family, Jesus declared that their own actions revealed them to be children of the devil, John chapter 8, verse 44. No crowd would respond well to being called children of the devil, and this crowd was no different. They went so far as to claim Jesus must be demon-possessed, to think that if Adam and all the rest of the prophets died, Jesus' own followers would not. Chapter 8, verses 52 through 53. We do well to note that the contrast Jesus set up can apply broadly to anyone who claims to be a child of Abraham and therefore chosen by God, including Christians today, but acts in evil ways that contradict this heritage. Neither Jesus' words here nor anywhere else justify violence against Jews, past or present. Verse 1, but Jesus went to the Mount of Olives. Verse 2, at dawn he appeared again in the temple courts, where all the people gathered around him, and he sat down to teach them. Verses 3 through 4, the teachers of the law and the Pharisees brought in a woman caught in adultery. They made her stand before the group and said to Jesus, "Teacher, this woman was caught in the act of adultery." Verse 5, in the law Moses commanded us to stone such women. Now, what do you say? Verse 6, they were using this question as a trap in order to have a basis for accusing him. But Jesus bent down and started to write on the ground with his finger. Verse 7, when they kept on questioning him, he straightened up and said to them, "Let any one of you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at her." Verse 8, again he stooped down and wrote on the ground. Verse 9, at this, those who heard began to go away one at a time, the older ones first, until only Jesus was left with the woman still standing there. Verse 10, Jesus straightened up and asked her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" Verse 11, "No one, sir," she said. "Then neither do I condemn you," Jesus declared. "Go now and leave your life of sin." Verse 56, "Your father Abraham rejoiced at the thought of seeing my day. He saw it and was glad." Verse 57, "You are not yet 50 years old," they said to him, "and you have seen Abraham." Verse 58, "Very truly I tell you," Jesus answered, "before Abraham was born, I am." Verse 59, "At this, they picked up stones to stone him, but Jesus hid himself, slipping away from the temple grounds." A brief summary. When laws are violated, there are consequences that must follow. According to the law of Moses, the punishment for adultery in Jesus' time was death by stoning, Leviticus chapter 20, verse 10. When the Pharisees brought to Jesus the woman accused of adultery, they were not concerned with keeping moral order. They were trying to trap Jesus, using this woman as a pawn. Jesus refused to allow the law to be manipulated in that way. According to the law, the man involved in the act of adultery should also have been stoned. We do not know why only the woman was brought to Jesus, when the law clearly stated that both adulterers were to receive the same punishment. Jesus was aware of the woman's sin. He also knew of the sins of the others surrounding him in the temple. If she was to be punished, should they not also be punished? Laws should be applied consistently. When it came to sin, Jesus, unlike the upright and holy Pharisees, sought to help a sinner rather than merely punish one. He offered forgiveness instead of condemnation for the woman caught in adultery. With his non-judgmental attitude, Jesus offered this woman the opportunity to start over with a clean slate and turn from her life of sin, saying, "Go now and leave your life of sin." Jesus did not deny equality with God. He confirmed it. He affirmed that Abraham rejoiced at the thought of seeing my day. God promised that in Abraham, all peoples on earth will be blessed, Genesis chapter 12, verse 3. Jesus would fulfill that promise, Acts chapter 3, verse 25. Then Jesus affirmed that he lived before Abraham. In making that affirmation, he claimed for himself the name of God revealed to Moses, "I am," Exodus chapter 3, verse 13. Jesus's opponents were outraged. Thank you so much for watching. Join me soon for the next backstory. Stay safe and may God bless.